Good afternoon. I'm Damian Musiani, and here's the latest in what can only be described as still 2020. In the aftermath of last night's vice presidential debate between Kamala Harris and Mike Pence, the socially crowned winner was none other than the housefly that brazenly seduced Pence's hair for 2 minutes on camera. Confirming the sighting was none other than the Brundlefly himself, Jeff Goldblum, who remarked that the insect was nearly impossible to detect, much like Goldblum's current acting career. As for the next presidential debate, it was announced earlier this morning that round two of Trump versus Biden would be held virtually due to President Trump's COVID-19 status and because these two men just can't play nice together. However, Trump told Fox Business News today that he is not going to waste his time debating on Zoom. He is much too busy as president to spend any time online. Not to worry, because Jeff Goldblum said he has plenty of time on his hands these days and offered to debate in Trump's place by proxy. The actual Pence fly turned down the opportunity to step in for Trump, as it is currently in talks with Netflix for its own comedy special. Pence fly is also now represented by WME. But if you miss seeing all that hot air swirling around, you need only turn your attention to the South. Hurricane season continues to focus on the state of Louisiana as the unfortunately named Hurricane Delta, yep, has now trained its small eye on the Big Easy. Vice President Pence said last night that there are the same number of hurricanes now as 100 years ago, yet the World Meteorological Organization actually ran out of names for storms last month and has switched to the Greek alphabet for only the second time in recorded history. When that runs out, yes, we will be forced to use hieroglyphics to name our storms. We here in the newsroom are rooting hard for a Hurricane Potstan. Meanwhile, back on dry land, the Nobel Prize for Literature was awarded to American poet Louise Gluck, whose writing, and I quote, makes individual existence universal. You see, until now, you could only be yourself locally. Now Gluck has opened up the self-identity floodgates for all cell-based organisms. Says Pencefly, Louise, you complete me. That's your 2020 hindsight for today. See you next time.